Hello guys, welcome back of course to another video of American Truck Sim. And yeah, like I said, I just want to keep watching my beautiful truck. As you can see, it's quite empty. There are no lights on the roof, there are no lights on the front bumper, no beacons, no nothing actually. So look at those lights on the back, that's just poor, man. And the longer I keep driving and the more afraid I get that this is it. We're not gonna get any, you know, bars for the roof or bars for at the front, and that would really suck. But who knows, maybe I'm wrong. So let's start trucking again. The trailer is waiting. It was just 15. No. It was 35 kilometers away from where we were, and I thought, yeah, you know, it's quite a good job, so I'll drive well until I have 5 kilometers left. I'll park it and then I'm gonna let you guys in. You don't have to see me drive 35 kilometers to get close to the trailer. I like doing this, you know, get close to the trailer, get the outside view, talk a little bit about how it was and how far I had to drive to get a trailer, and then pick up the trailer together with you. And that sucks. My screen just popped away. I got a little warning there. It's all cool. So here is the trailer. Ooh, ice cream again. Well, here in LA or California. Well, let's see, here we are. I'm gonna get cars again, get paid 7,000 euros. So like I said, I did want an average today of 5,000, so far so good. Well, the 3,000 of course was not good, let's be fair. Can I make... oh no, totally. I'm totally off, man, you're totally off, that's better. Let's take the right mirror because it's not moving. Slowly back up into it because it's new cars. And they are going to be shipped, I guess, to another country. And they decided to trust me with this job, which I'm really, really grateful for, of course. Oh, I'm taking it over the step sidewalk. Ugh. And I'm going the wrong way also, so you have two exits. Well, whatever. Look at this, guys. Nice. Very expensive cars, it looks like. Ooh. 5 of them. So I'm driving around with at least 150,000 euros for sure. Let's take a look at the papers. 10 tons of cars. We are going to San Francisco, the port of San Francisco, so they're going to be shipped off. I'm getting 7,000 euros for a trip of 587 kilometers. I need to rest in 5 hours, so better we don't stop the truck. I wanted to give away. Let's start driving. This will be a nice job, like I said, 7,000 euros. Yeah, you know, then you have to drive around 600 kilometers. And I'm still not finding the jobs above 10,000. Skrull already has it, Arthur already has it, so that's a little bit sad. But they also I think they have 3 points in long distance, and that means they can do jobs over 1,000 kilometers. And I think that's just now, you know, a little bit too much to start out with. Sixth gear, what the hell am I doing now? No. This is better. Yes. For some reason I like even numbers better in gearing. I'm not sure why, but you know, the 1, 3, 9, 13, it scares me. Well, 2.5 is also still not very good, but I don't know. 2.58, then 11, then 13. Well, just feels, starting with 2 just feels good. Not with 1 and then 3, but 2 and 5. I don't know, it's weird. It's just a little bit weird. Let's bring these cars. Gonna get shipped maybe to Germany, to Holland. No, that's of course not correct. I don't think they're gonna be shipped to my country, because we have to pay extra then for to import them, I think. Because I have a friend of a friend of a friend of a friend who knows somebody who is a friend of him, and you know how it goes. I know a guy. And yeah, he loves cars. Well, I love cars also, but he's in a club, which is called the 900 Club. And if you want to join that club, you have to have a car. Yeah, this is crazy, but I thought it was only in movies, but it's really the case in real life also. If you want to join this club, because it's called the 900 Club, you have to have a car with 900 horsepower. Wow, right? I mean, wow. And my friend wanted to join that club, so he bought... Oh, I always forget the name. Toyota? The Mac. Toyota Mac. I totally... It just slipped my mind. I knew it and I thought, oh, I'm gonna tell the story. Well, it was quite a fast car, and he first had an older one. And they live in an industrial terrain. They hire a box, you know, a garage box, and every week they meet there. And I was there once. I saw 5 cars, all the same cars. And you know, they start first talking a little bit, of course, and then they put the cars together a little bit, and then they open the hoods, and then they go swapping. You know, they just swap things. You know, so this guy goes like, okay, guys, I have a new turbo. I have 1 turbo left, and who wants it? And I'm like, okay. So this guy asks, yeah, how much is it? Oh, it's a 10,000 euro turbo, but it's too big. You know, I have a new one, and this old one is too big. And he said, yeah, okay, I'll take it. And he looks, you know, if he fits it in his car. So it's unbelievable, but... You know, he ended up with 914 horsepower in his own car, and took it for a spin with a friend. And straight line speed, of course, fantastic. I think they went 275 kilometers an hour. But he said, "Yeah, going, you know, making a turn with so much power was a little bit difficult." And 2 years ago, he ended up buying a whole new car, the Mac. He had the Mac 5 or 4, and then the new one was, I don't know, I'm not into those cars. And he went the same way, buffed it up above 900 kilometers. So yeah, you know, you have those people who really, really love cars. And one of them started the club, I guess. He had a business called Lost Boys. Ah, damn it. When he was quite young, he sold it for many, many millions. And then he thought, well, I'm going to take up a hobby. I'm going to buy a car and put 900 horsepower in it. So I always think, you know, that famous people or very rich people, rich people, famous people, they say, I'm not happy, I'm rich, and money does not make happiness, and, you know, and very rich people say, no, money does not, you know, it's not going to make your life better, you're not going to be happy. And I can, in one way, I can understand that, because if you have, if you have so much money, you're going to be a little bit careful, because you're going to get people, with business opportunities. So I can understand in that way that people say, I'm going to sleep here, just to be sure. You know, that you say money does not make happiness, it's not going to make you happy, get a better life. I can understand that, but on the other side, I say money, being a millionaire, let's say being a millionaire makes life more easy for you, 100%, you know, I mean, and I've had this discussion with a couple of people, you know, they say, why? I mean, let's look at it, you know, famous people, they get followed everywhere, blah, 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 stuff like that, they cannot do anything private anymore. And I say, at that point, that's true. But, you know, when they started Rain, that's not very nice. Well, let's go again. You know, they wanted to be famous. So they knew they had to get some roles for some good movies. Well, Tom Cruise got it. Everybody famous got it. But also, you know, it's the fans that make you, right? I mean, Tom Cruise makes his first 5 movies. People watch it. Everybody's like, wow, fantastic, fantastic. He makes a new movie. He can ask 50 million. Because that many people watched his other movie. So in a way, the fans are making him big. Now, he's a big star now. Now he's crying that, you know, I'm not happy, everybody's following me. Yeah, dude, that's the price of being famous, you know, but in a way, he can do what he wants. Although I can understand that some people say, well, you know, going to my trash cans, they follow me everywhere, the questions and stuff like that, but still, you know, still. You can also have, be very, that's better. You can be also very relaxed with it. I'm sure there are other famous people who don't have that problem and just take it as a job, and you know, they have a role model they are, and they keep it, they think it's very serious, so they keep that. And on the other side, you know, when I say if you're a millionaire and you have like 27 to 37 million euros, yeah, okay, you're not going to be happy about it, but it's more easy. If I have an accident with my car, I'm in trouble, you know, I cannot afford a new car, and, or, you know, I'm just in deep shit, you know. If I was a millionaire with 37 million euro and I bought a Mercedes SLR, SLS, SLR or a McLaren, you know, and I wrecked it, I would laugh, because in 1 hour I have a new car. It's as simple as that, you know. And that's why I say having money makes it more easy, because it opens doors, you know. Well, not on the job market, because if you have 37 million euros, you're not going to work anymore. You're just going to, you know, find a good hobby and play golf all day, or tennis, or I don't know, sailing maybe. But yeah, I do think that it makes it more easy, your life. I mean, what's so hard? What's so bad about if you break something and you can right away say, oh, you know, okay, I smacked my car. Ah, too bad, leave it. I'm gonna call a taxi, or right away I'm gonna call the dealer and order a new one. You know, I mean, that does make you happy, right? it's really boring. So that's how I think, you know. I mean, money is important. And the more money you have, the better you feel, you know, for sure. Let's be fair here. Oh my god. This is... Oh. Let's put it a little bit faster, please. Oh, it was already on fast. Okay, lights on. Very good. Or else I get a ticket, of course. And now it's storming. Wow. Well, this is different than normal. On a Monday. 7:30 in the morning. And right away, I don't know, it rains, it's a little bit darker, so you don't feel as happy as when the sun is shining. At least that's what I have. I love the sun. This turn, of course, with 89 kilometers an hour, let's be fair here. And I had it in neutral. Alright, alright. Fuel. I do need to fuel up. I hope after this job, I think so. Let's take a quick look. No problem there. I can still drive 430 kilometers, so that's great. Wow, it's really thundering there. The gods are angry. Oakland, hello. Welcome to Oakland. Well, welcome to almost finishing my fifth trailer of the day, my fifth job of the day. So, going very well. I want to finish with 8. That would be awesome, like I said, you know, if I can do that every day. I started late. I started after dinner, so I could have started a little bit earlier, maybe made 10, but yeah, I woke up a little bit grumpy. I'm gonna pay 19 euros again, I guess. Right through. Oh, thank you. Watch your mirrors. I don't see anything, so let's go over this beautiful bridge. And then we're in San Francisco for the last 90 kilometers. Cats and dogs. Hopefully I can park this trailer inside something, so I'm not getting wet. I hate it when I get wet. Or when it's outside. Yeah. Then I have no choice, I have to go outside. Trailer and stuff like that, all the wires and couplings. Yeah, then I have to run to the office to sign the papers, to check everything and stuff like that. And then of course I can go, they will wire the money to my account, I guess. That's how it works, right? Well, normally of course. And this is... I know how it goes here. In Holland, I'm not sure, in America or the yes or no. When you have work for a company and you have a client and the client buys something from you because you sell things. Ooh, that was I was going quite fast there. This is a very difficult turn because of the trailer, but it's okay. When they buy something of you, you're gonna send them a bill. And I think they have 1 month to pay. They don't have to pay right away. So you know, for me, that's a little bit of a problem, because if all my customers did not pay and thought, well, you know what, we're going to make money ourselves, and at the end of the month, we're going to pay him, every day I lose 4,000 euros, so that will cost me around 80,000 euros. So that's not good. I need my customers to pay quick, because I need the money. But that's how it goes in Holland. I know at my company, you know, the client could choose pay in 1 week, 2 weeks, right away, you know, or end of the month. So. Truck driver, of course, having your own company, you don't want your clients to pay at the end of the month. You give them 2 or 3 days and then you say, well, sorry dude, but I really need that money now. It's just he still had his roof down. Funny. Well dude, your car is wrecked. Your leather got wet, you know, so. Let's try again. Sun is out. Nice. Let's see. The port is here, so. I don't think this was. How do they want it? Are they crazy? Oh, no, no, that's not. Oh my god. I'm not sure if I'm up for this. I don't think I can turn here. Because I have to go between something. This is not the right angle. Oh, steered wrong. Trailer. Nope. Nice. Job done. Great job. 636 kilometers in total. 7,000. Some nice XP. And I made level 12. Nice. Now I need to have 2,700 XP. Oh yeah, I can. Should I take this one? I don't want actually jobs above 1,000 euros yet. I'm liking the ones, you know, until 600 kilometers. But job done. I'm gonna find a fuel station, and I see one there already. So let's set our navigation for that one. Nothing closer, I think. Oh, you cannot zoom. No, I'll take this one. And then of course I'm gonna find another trailer, another job, and then I will pick you up, guys. We'll drive to it, hook it on, and then we'll do the journey together. So thank you guys for watching, of course, and remember, burn rubber, not your soul. Keep trucking, guys.